Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is sets part three. We're going to do more involved examples involving intersection, union, and complement, where it takes more than one step, and we're using order of operations. For this universal set, and these two subsets C and F, and we do these four problems on this video. All right, let's take this universal set. So the universe is the numbers 1 through 9. And we have two subsets I've created. One is E containing 1, 3, 5, and 7, and the other is F containing 4, 5, and 6. So how would we do these two problems? So the first one is E union F complement. Well, this takes more than one step. I have to use my order of operation, so I first have to do E union F. All right, so let's write that parentheses. And E union F is a set, so I need to put it in braces, right? And let's list the numbers in E union F. All right, so let's look at E and F, and what are all the numbers? You put them together. I see that 5 is listed twice, but all the rest are unique. So I've got 1, 3. I also have 4 because that's an F, right? I have 5, I have 6, and 7. So we did the union in the previous video, so make sure that you remember how to get the union. And now I'm going to put a parentheses around that. In other words, I'm now writing E union F as this set that it really is. These numbers, 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And I want the complement of that. Right now, what's the complement? It means all the numbers in the universe except these numbers, right? So what does that give me? Look at the universal set. What's not in here? All right, a 2, an 8, and a 9. So that is E union F complement. Now remember, when you put these two together, right, if you have a set and its complement, then altogether they should make up the universal set, right? And they should be different numbers, of course. All right, let's do the second part. How about E complement union F complement? This is not the same problem. There's no parentheses, so first I have to do E complement and I have to do F complement, and then I need to take their union. So let's do that. First, we've got to take E complement. So we look up here at E. We want everything in the universal set except 1, 3, 5, and 7. So that's this set, 2, 4, 6, 8, and 9. And I'm writing that union symbol. And I need to do F complement. That's everything in the universe except 4, 5, and 6. So that's 1, 2, 3, 7, 8, 9. Remember, you don't have to write the numbers in order, but sometimes it's kind of confusing if you don't write them in order. So that's why I'm writing them in order from smallest to largest. But the order does not matter. Now I need to take their union. So if it's in one of these sets, it's in the union, right? And if I want to write them in order from 1 to 9, I'm just going to start with the number 1 and see if it's in at least one of the sets. So is 1 in the union? Yes, because it's in F complement over here. Is 2 in? Yes. How about 3? Yes, there's a 3 somewhere. How about 4? Yes. Is there a 5? No, so 5's not in the union. How about 6? Yes, there's a 6. There's 7 is in there. There's an 8. And there's a 9. Now, someone else might have done it this way. They may have just listed the first set, which is 2, 4, 6, 8, and 9. And then listed the numbers in the second set, but just don't double list. So 1, not in there yet. 2's already there. 3's not in there. 7, not in there yet. 8, it's already in there. 9's already in there. Okay, so those should be the same number of elements, the same exact elements. Let's say I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 numbers here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, the same 8 numbers. So how you figure that out doesn't matter. So what I want you to notice here, though, is that these are definitely not the same. E union F complement is not the same, so it's not equal to E complement union F complement. All right, so now I want you to try a different example. I want you to start off with the same universal set and E and F, and what we're going to do is E intersect F in parentheses complement and then E complement intersect F complement. All right, so here's what I want you to do. So here's the same universal set, the same original sets I had, E and F. I want you to do E intersect F complement and then E complement intersect F complement. So put the video on pause, try this one on your own first. All right, so I've got to do E intersect F, so I have to see what they have in common. Let's see, what do they have in common? I only see a 5, so you have to write that as a set. Remember, E intersect F is a set, so you need to put that in braces, right? And now we want the complement. Well, that means everything in the universe up here except 5. So that's the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, not 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. That's it. So I have a little bit more room for this one now. And I'm going to need it. So I'm going to do E complement first. Notice there's not, I'm doing order of operations here. So I have to do E complement first. And we actually did that in the previous problem. Remember, here's E complement right here, 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. And here was F complement. So the only difference is I'm going to change from a union to an intersection, right? So this first set is E complement, second set is F complement, and now we want to take their intersection, what these two sets have in common. And let's see, do they both have a 2? Yes. Sorry. All right, do they both have a 4? No. Do they have a 6? No. Do they have an 8? Yes. Do they both have a 9? Yes. So notice E intersection F complement over here. We get these numbers here, right? Everything except 5, but E complement intersection F complement is this. So these are not equal either. So just note, E intersection F complement is not the same thing as E complement intersection F complement. All right, here's something cool to notice. We started out with this universal set and these two subsets, E and F. And we computed E union F complement and E complement union F complement, and we realized those were not the same. So E union F complement was not equal to E complement union F complement. Then we did E intersection F complement, and we computed E complement intersection F complement, and similarly, we found out those were not the same. But there is something interesting here. Look at E union F complement, right? And look at E complement intersection F complement. They're the same. So, E union F complement ended up being E complement intersection F complement. Similarly, E intersection F complement, right, down here, is the same thing as this, E complement union F complement. So check it out. You can't just, you know, take this the complement out and put it in front and keep that union. What happens is it's sort of like a distributive property. To get rid of the parentheses, it ends up being an E complement and F complement, but whereas in the parentheses it was a union, outside the parentheses it's an intersection. And for the second one, when it was an intersection in the parentheses, the other one was a union. So that's kind of interesting. It's actually a distributive property with sets that works. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.